The Xbox One enters its 7th year in 2020, and by far we haven't seen any method how to hack it. One thing we can do is to replace or upgrade its internal hard drive to a bigger one, or use SSD to cut loading time significantly. And in this video, I will show you how to do it. So, let's get started. For this video, you will need an SSD. Please note that the maximum internal hard drive capacity for the Xbox One is 2 TB, so please don't buy anything larger than 2 TB as it is not usable. You also need 2 SATA to USB adapter, one for the source drive and one for the target drive. Get a metal spudger to disassemble the console. And you need to use a Torx 8 and 10 security screwdriver to unscrew the console case. Before doing anything, let's see how long it takes for the Xbox One to boot into the home screen using standard factory hard drive. Now let's try loading some game. For example, Forza Horizon 4. It took about 1 minute to load the game. Let's continue. and it took another 1 minute and 46 seconds to start playing Forza Horizon 4. Now let's try loading other game. For example, Super Lucky's Tale. It took 1 minute and 13 seconds to load the game. And another 24 seconds to play the game. We will turn off the console for now. Let's start disassembling the console. This guide works for any Xbox One variant. Since this is not a guide to disassemble the console, then I will fast forward this step. This is a stock factory hard drive. For my case, it is a standard 1TB 2.5-inch hard drive. Download the Xbox One hard drive partitioning script from GBATM. See the link in the description below. Prepare your SSD. Make sure it has the same capacity as the factory hard drive. Get the SATA to USB adapter, then connect it to the storage devices. Double-click the hard drive partitioning archive and extract it to your computer. You may need WinRAR or 7-zip to do it. At this step, connect the target hard drive or the SSD to your computer. Open the disk management by typing diskmgmt.msc at the start menu search form. Or you can click the Create and Format Hard Disk Partitions menu that is showing on your computer screen. You should be able to see the target drive inside the disk management. Delete all the partitions or the disk volume before proceeding with the guide. Now connect the source drive to your computer. And you should see it on the disk management. It is the one with 6 partitions. Open the Xbox One hard drive partitioning folder. Then open the Win folder. Right-click the Create Xbox Drive batch file and run it as an administrator. then press any key to continue. Since we want to duplicate the working source drive, then we need to press B. You need to select the source drive number. In my case, the source drive is this 4. And then, you need to select the target drive number. In my case, the target drive number is 3. Press Y to erase all the data on the target drive. On the next menu, select the hard drive size. Mine is 1TB, so I chose B. Close any pop-up windows and on the next menu, press Y. This process takes time and it is depending on the data volume inside the source drive. Mine took about 4 hours to finish. And then press any key to continue. When you see this management, now the target drive has 6 partitions. But each partition doesn't have the correct naming. We will need to rewrite the script to fix it. Since we are going to rename the target drive partition name, then it is better to remove the source drive from the computer. Make sure you only see the target drive inside the disk management. And then rerun the script as an administrator. Press any key to continue. Now at the main menu, press C to fix the partition name without formatting the drive. Select your target drive. In my case, it is this 3. Depending on your target drive size, I chose 1TB. Close any pop-up windows, then wait until it is done processing the drive. Refresh the disk management to see the newly updated partition name. Now we are ready to install the drive into the Xbox One. Again, I will fast forward the assembly process. Let's see how long is the booting process when using SSD. It took about 30 seconds to boot the console, so SSD doesn't have any advantages in the booting process. Now let's try loading Forza Horizon 4. Now you can see that loading games using SSD is much faster. Let's continue. Now this is the real deal. See the time differences. It is about 70 seconds. Now let's open Super Lucky Stale. It is slightly a little difference in Super Lucky Stale loading time. Let's continue. And again, we don't see any advantages of using SSD in this game. And please note that this game is not a AAA game. What we learn about this project is, the SSD does have advantages but only in some games, and I think mostly in AAA games. So that's it for now. Thanks for watching and see you guys on the next video.